Welcome to the Bremen Drop Talk.
But today from my office. In this video, I want to show you the GraviTower prototype in much more detail than we did in the previous videos. In the first part of this video, I want to show you what the GraviTower prototype is capable of and show you all the advantages it offers to those of you who are going to use it for your own experiments. And in the second part of this video, I want to show you in depth the facility and the individual subsystems that are working together to achieve this great microgravity quality. Well, let's get started.
For more than 30 years, we are carrying out experiments under microgravity conditions. And from now on, we are doing this not only in the Bremen Drop Tower, which offers the world's longest microgravity duration, but also in the new GraviTower, which offers the world's highest repetition rate. The GraviTower can perform up to 960 experimental flights each day, and thus is able to meet the increased demand of scientific research.
Okay, let's begin with the repetition rate, as this was the main incentive for the development of the GraviTower. The Bremen Drop Tower offers up to 3 flights per day, which is quite a lot compared to other microgravity facilities, but scientists kept asking for more, at least 30 times more. But why is this so important? Obviously, with more repetitions of the exact same experiment, you get much clearer and much more reliant experiment results. In other words, the signal-to-noise ratio improves, but it takes 100 flights to get a 10 times better result. And also, higher repetition rates allow you to change your experimental setups between flights, meaning that you are able to explore huge parameter spaces. This is especially helpful for very complex experiments where the outcome is not easily predictable. The GraviTower is capable of performing up to 1,000 flights per day, as the average time between flights is only 45 seconds. But if your experiment benefits from it, you can directly perform 2 flights after another. Another advantage is that you can have access to your experiment between flights. It only takes about 10 seconds until you have your hands on your experiment. You can rotate it inside the slider to get access to every part of the experiments. You can change samples, you can adjust parameters. And after closing the doors of the slider, you can immediately fly again. This easy access was implemented to achieve the highest possible repetition rates out of the GraviTower, not as a theoretical number, but under real lab conditions and for every kind of experiment.
Like the Drop Tower, the GraviTower is making use of the principle of a vertical parabola. Like on a trampoline, an object is already in free flight after an initial acceleration, during its fall up and when it's falling down again.
As we have just seen, vertical parabolas in Drop Towers consist of an initial acceleration, the actual parabola when the experiment is in microgravity, and the finishing deceleration. In the GraviTower, we do not want to excite any vibrations or eigenfrequencies inside the experiment during the initial acceleration. This way, we do not have to wait for any vibrations to decay in the microgravity time, and we achieve the longest possible usable microgravity duration. If your experiment can withstand 4G of acceleration and deceleration, the GraviTower offers you 2.56 seconds of microgravity. But actually, this is completely up to you. If your experiment can only withstand 2G of acceleration and or deceleration, the GraviTower still offers you 2 seconds of microgravity. Next to the accelerations, you can actually adjust and define the kinematics all by yourself in a wide range. And this is very easy to do, and you can actually do it yourself just like this. You can adjust the initial acceleration and the deceleration independent from each other. And of course, you can add a smoothing function for the transition into microgravity. Consider these kinematics as part of the parameter space that your experiment can use to find its own sweet spot. Let's go back to the video and have a look at some test flights. You will get a feeling for the high quality we achieved and the smooth transition into microgravity.
In this test flight, you can see the gentle initial acceleration, the floating in weightlessness, and the soft deceleration. This high quality and repeatable boundary conditions are essential for scientific research. The experiments we performed in the GraviTower so far showed that we achieved a very high quality of weightlessness, similar to the Bremen Drop Tower.
As you have seen, with these first flights, we instantly achieved a quality usable for scientific experiments. Now we are fine-tuning the system to achieve the same high quality as we do in the catapult system of the drop tower. All users of the GraviTower are supported in the mechanical and electrical integration and testing of the experiment, as well as in software development and automation, in the same way as users of the drop tower. A significant innovation regards the automation possibilities. In the GraviTower, the experiment can take over control and trigger flights directly. After the experiment is mounted into the slider, you can start to operate the experiment and the GraviTower yourself. The experiment can remain inside the slider all the time. But there's much more to consider when we talk about quality in drop towers, such as timing and synchronization of the experiment with the facility. As you already heard, the experiment can operate the GraviTower by itself, and this is a big part of synchronization. The variable latency between the theoretical and the real transition into microgravity is below 10 milliseconds, and this very short variable latency allows the experiment to perform any kind of time-critical preparation before flight. This could be, for example, the positioning of a droplet or the ignition of a combustion at just the right moment. But now let me show you some more flights with a variety of simple experiments. This little figure has flexible feet and a high center of gravity, but even during the acceleration with up to 4G, it stays upright. It lifts off very softly with a very small relative velocity, and it keeps standing upright when landing and during deceleration. This flame, as expected, forms a sphere, and also here there is no flickering visible. And finally, this low viscosity oil forms a meniscus with an eigenfrequency during microgravity, and again, no imperfections like surface ripples are visible. This shows again the soft acceleration and deceleration and the smooth transition into high quality microgravity. I hope this gave you a good insight in what you can expect from the GraviTower Bremen prototype today. Let's move on to the second part of the video and let me show you how the system works.
So, how does this work? The GraviTower uses an airtight slider, which is accelerated against gravity and air drag by this hydraulic winch. Therefore, this system does not require a vacuum chamber.
Let's start with the drive. The GraviTower uses an hydraulic winch instead of the maybe more obvious solution of using an electromagnetic drive. We are using an hydraulic winch for two main reasons. The first reason is that we wanted to avoid any magnetic fields close to the experiments, which might interfere with the experiment setups themselves. The second reason to use a hydraulic winch is its slow but powerful acceleration, which means its low dynamics. This might sound weird, as we want the drive to accelerate the slider with up to 5G. But the point is that we want the winch to accelerate the slider with a very low frequency harmonic time function and not with any higher frequencies which might excite eigenfrequencies inside the experiments. The hydraulic winch was developed together with Bosch Rexroth, who carried out extensive simulations over a period of 3 years to adapt their hydraulic systems to the needs of the GraviTower and to optimize the controller. The drive consists of two winches. The primary winch is accelerating the slider, while the secondary winch is actually working against the primary one to ensure that the steel cables are under tension at any time. The drive takes about 50 liters of oil at 350 bar pressure for every flight, and the pressure tank was dimensioned so that we can perform two flights directly after another. At the end of each flight, when decelerating the slider, we can use the energy of the slider to build up new oil pressure. This increases the efficiency of the whole system and, of course, also the repetition rate. Let's have a look at another part of the GraviTower system, the slider. During motion, the slider is carrying the experiment and protects it from the outer air drag. Next to this main functionality, the slider also carries two service modules, a pneumatic service module and an electronic service module. Pneumatics are used for the release caging mechanism, of course, but also for the doors and some safety brakes. Electrically, the slider hosts several radio links and a computer for autonomous safety measures. The stiffness of the slider is essential to avoid vibrations that could become disturbances to the experiment. This is another factor contributing to the very high overall quality. With this being said, let's have a look at this centerpiece, the release caging mechanism.
Scientific experiments require an excellent quality of weightlessness. Therefore, already during the initial acceleration, the experiment is mechanically decoupled from the slider in all but the vertical axis. During microgravity time, the experiment is fully decoupled and free-floating inside the slider.
The release and caging mechanism is the mechanical heart of the new GraviTower, and it is a completely new type of decoupling systems. The basic principle is that we do not decouple all 6 degrees of freedom in just one mechanics, but we have several mechanic systems for several degrees of freedom. What I have here to demonstrate the basic principle to you is the upper part of the release caging mechanism, consisting of two air bearings, a flat air bearing at the bottom and a spherical air bearing at the top. When I open this valve, you can see that we have immediately a decoupling in this flat air bearing in 2 degrees of freedom, in the horizontal translational degrees of freedom. And when I open the other valve, you can see that we have mechanical decoupling in rotational degrees of freedom in this spherical air bearing. And we have 3 degrees of freedom because we can also turn in this degree. In this picture, you can see the full setup of the release caging mechanism. Here on top, you can see the upper part that I have just demonstrated to you. And below this part, we have 2 more air bushings for the vertical translational degree of freedom. Here you can see the vertical part of the release caging mechanism in action during a flight. All 3 mechanisms together make the release caging mechanism and achieve this very high quality of microgravity for our experiments. This new release caging mechanism has several advantages. The main advantage is that we are now able to decouple this 5 degrees of freedom already during the initial acceleration. Therewith, we avoid that any mechanical vibrations from the slider or the drive are transmitted into the experiment, which would have to decay before we have real microgravity quality. The second advantage, as you have already seen, is that we can use this release caging mechanism to turn the experiment inside the slider between flights, and this is giving us access to every part of the experiment. And finally, this allows us to achieve very high repetition rates with any kind of experiment. The mechanical decoupling of 5 degrees of freedom also works for partial gravity, which takes us to the last chapter of this video, our future plans.
This means today we are offering the longest microgravity duration and the highest repetition rate worldwide.
Now that you have got a first impression what the GraviTower offers you already, let me show you what you can look forward to in the future. Next to the very high repetition rates, the second main request from the scientific community has always been the possibility to do partial gravity. Like Moon and Mars gravity, for instance, since the residual accelerations are very low, the GraviTower will also offer asteroid gravity. These are completely novel features in any microgravity facility. In the longer term, we are updating our software to allow the experiment to define the kinematics by itself. Also, we are implementing new options for you to make use of AI algorithms for data evaluation. You guessed it, we are aiming for experimental data that is basically writing itself. So stay tuned for more of our updates.